Hello and welcome to the second week's challenge of Paint with J-Man's weekly challenges. That did not sound half as catchy or even like nearly as catchy as I thought it would, which is fine because that's not what we're here for. We're here to look at this week's submissions for the current challenge on my Discord channel. Just by the way, if you're interested in joining my Discord channel, you can using the link on my Instagram bio. Or if you're watching this on YouTube for some odd reason, you can use that using that it's down there. Before we get into this week's challenge, it's important that I let you know what the challenge was, what the prompt was. If you watched last week's video, the prompt was holiday. I wanted to go with something that's more of a, why are the things always floating around? For this week's challenge, I wanted to go with something that's a little bit more open-ended, creatively challenging and fun. This week's prompt is me if I were in a fantasy movie. So for this week's challenge, there weren't any creative restrictions as such. One could do anything that they wanted to do. If they wanted, they could also like explain their concept a little bit. Like, hey, I've drawn myself with a mechanical unicorn because I am going to bring justice to, I don't know, something. So you can make yourself a hero, a villain, human, non-human, change your body, give yourself a tail. Go in the year 2050 or go back to the 1950s. I mean, the limits are non-existent. Go crazy. This is what I said to my Discord channel members and those who want to take part in this week's challenge. So without further ado, let's get into the submissions of this week's challenge, of course. So we'll start with Zoe's submission, or Snoop Foodle, as we can see here. Zoe here decided to make a rendition of themselves as Ma Kali, I think, because that's what I remember seeing from their Instagram. And I think that there's a lot of things that I like about this. And I think it's quite like exciting. There are obviously like some places which can be better, areas of this illustration that can be leveled up. But as an idea, as the concept of me if I were in a fantasy movie, or whoever the creative is, from that perspective, I think it's like quite interesting. Idea wise, like it's really well done. Execution wise, it's all right. Like, you know, I see that Zoe is like comfortable painting some parts and not comfortable painting some parts. Like, I see that Zoe feels that they're comfortable painting anatomy, but when it comes to like painting external objects, or objects that are interacting with anatomy, they're kind of, you know, like a little bit lost. But Zoe is joining the next batch of Paint with J-Man. And if you're somebody who draws, why not? I mean, I can only say that it helps. You have to find out if it helps or not. And maybe this might help you make a decision. I don't know. Okay. Anyway, so I really like this. I think, you know, the framing obviously could be much better. There are parts of the illustration that are getting chopped, but apart from that, I quite like it idea wise. I wish there was something more unique about it though. Like, you know, apart from just the addition of horns, like what if it was a completely like barbaric sort of a rendition of Zoe as Ma Kali? You know, that could be something interesting. So it's a good attempt. I really like it. Anatomy is decent. The way you painted the body is decent. The way you painted like the props is also pretty good. I do see that you understand light and shadow pretty well, and I'm really excited to see what you do next. And with that, I think it's time for us to move on to the next piece, which is by Sankey Khopri. You guys have like really funny names, just by the way. Snoop Foodle, Sankey Khopri, Dhruv Patel. It's just like really funny. Okay, Sankey here did this piece, which I really like. I don't know how much of this is like me, because if you're like this, Sankey Gorby, I'm scared of you. I'm sorry for that joke. You're jacked as fuck. Also, what are you eating, man? I really like it. Like, I think it's pretty stylized. It's very, you know, the understanding of gear and like what the character wears and all of that, that really dictates like how the interpretation of that character is going to be. And I feel like this character belongs in a world which is like sort of like dystopic, but not like, you know, futuristic. Like, it kind of reminds me of like a less techie crossover between like Cyberpunk 2077, let's just call it that, and He-Man, because of like the skeleton head thing happening, which I really like, by the way. I really like how stylized the hair is. Like, the hair is coming from like the skeletons, like the mask's top. I really like the way you did the flame. I really like how you done the shoes. I kind of wish that you put a little bit more effort into the background, like really built a world around this character. But I do remember speaking with you and you told me that there is a time constraint, and I completely get it. I am really, really excited to see what you do next. My only feedback would be to I don't want to feed you information, because that's what I do in my classes. So join my classes if you're interested. But the second thing, but the second best thing is that I can say is that really see where your light is coming from, you know? Like, once you understand where your light is coming from, you will know what part of the illustration will be dark and what part of the image will be bright. I mean, I'm just saying that there's a fireball in his hand. You've done like a good job with like the highlights on the hand, but the body is not reacting to the light of the flame. So that would just bring it a lot closer to, you know, making it look more dramatic. I'm not saying make it realistic. That's never like ever what I'm saying. But just like adding a sense of reality makes your characters a little bit more powerful. Like, it makes them feel like they belong in a believable imaginescape. New word, imaginescape. Okay, so let's read what Dhruv has written here. So I try to imagine me in a bit in future where I'm about to steal a quest, which is a Wacom stylus here, and some bots are preventing me to do so. And I gave them the tag of social media apps, which is the most distracting thing for me while drawing. I mean, they're a social commentary. Mm-hmm. Tip of the hat to you, sir. But I quite like it. Like, I think it's pretty well done. I really, really like how dynamic it is. I see that you added like a sense of motion, like in the background with blurring. I don't know how much of that makes sense, because there's not... See, like, you add a sense of motion when the understanding of planes change, you know? Like, if you feel like a plane is shifting by too fast compared to the plane that you're on, that means that the other object would look as if it's... There's too much light on my glasses. As if it's like in motion, you know? Or I'm calling a plane, but what I mean is like a subject, basically. Like, a plane is a surface, what I'm saying. So I don't know how effective the motion blur is here. It doesn't really add much to the image, but I really like the anatomy bit. I really like how you've thought about the line of motion, how you've thought about, like, you know, shoulders, and how there is a sense of weight in this subject. A lot of times when people create something, even like movies, even production houses, when they create something which has an obscure sense of weight, like say when they create like big mechs running through the city destroying things, the sense of weight can get lost sometimes. I like that there is a sense of weight here because of this introduction of gravity. About the bots, I'm not really sure if just putting an icon is the best way that you can, you know, depict the idea of like being distracted by social media bots. Also, I feel like the risk here is too little. Like, it feels like you're a pretty like capable katana sword wielding like warrior, and these are like some fuck all bots trying to guard this like pen with like green lasers. You know, adding some more dynamism, adding a story to it. Like, you have a story in mind, but adding, like, going through a prototype stage, like, hey, deciding what layout works best would be suitable for you. Watch, like, how concept artists work, and you will understand, like, you know, the importance of the perfect way to represent a frame. Like, all of the apps basically could have just had something that, like, connected them to your idea. Then I would recommend that you rethink a little bit of, like, how you plan on, you know, using your props and the objects and the subjects in the frame to create a powerful, more stronger visual. My final sort of comments on this are, I really like the anatomy, I really like the sort of muted color frame. It kind of brings attention to, you know, the main subject here, which is you. And yeah, I think you've done a good job. I'm really looking forward to see what you do in the future. Okay, so this is by Suramya. Suramya is also a student of Paint with J-Man, both level 1 and level 1.5. Be like her. Join Paint with J-Man. Okay, I'll stop doing this. I'm just kidding. I won't stop. I'll keep doing this. The whole point of this is to let people know that, hey, I teach. So learn, maybe. I don't know. But right, Suramya has done a pretty good job, I think, in terms of, like, I don't know what it is, like, the character is really, but I do sense, like, a massive energy of power. I know that sentence sounded whack as fuck, but, like, what I mean is that when I look at this frame, I do feel that this character has a lot of power, is what I was trying to say in the last sentence. Suramya has a really, like, fun way of drawing things, and I quite like the way that she creates the subjects and the illustrations that she creates. I really like that she added, like, that she put in effort into adding stuff in the background, like these unicorns, or, like, I think these are unicorns with, like, rhino horns, or, like, I don't know, these weird looking creatures. Like, that is, like, really exciting, because I think Suramya is, like, truly trying to build a sort of a universe here. Like, things that I would ask Suramya to maybe work on are, number one, hands too big. I mean, obviously that could be, like, a stylistic choice, but, you know, if it's balanced everywhere, then it makes sense. Like, you know, if your hand is big on the right side of your body, it should make sense for the hand on the left side to also be big, which isn't happening here. There's a slight disbalance here. I also think that you should maybe read up a little bit more on color theory. Like, color theory, when you get into the idea of color theory, it can get very, very, like, arresting. Like, hey, does this color work with that? It's not always the case. But if you take some liberty and understand color theory, you can get a great combination of just vibes, bro, and logic. So purple on an orange, yellow, like this shade of purple, there is a shade of purple that works here, but it's not this one. So I want you to explore that. I really would like for you to think about, like, the sword, think about the framing a little bit more, because I do feel you can just extend the canvas and add, like, more, like, see, the toes are getting cut, the wings are getting cut. That is not ideal in a perfect sense, but if it's a stylistic choice, then fuck what I'm saying. Go do ahead. Like, go do ahead. Go ahead with what you're doing. But if you do think that the framing is not something that you consciously thought about, think about it and see if you would like to frame it a little bit better. Like always, I really like how you've painted it. I really like how you've built, like, you know, objects and like structures, like these little bones in the back of the wings, and you know, these, like, unicorn rhino type characters, the sword. I really like it. I hope you finish it soon, because I know it's hella incomplete right now, but I mean, this is really good. And yeah, that's it. Let's go. Okay, so this is a piece that Mansha did. So Mansha has said this. So I love being in nature, everything about it amazing me, hence I imagine myself in one. She is maybe daughter of Mother Earth, healer of the earth, someone who is her true self when around nature. Also, this is my first time making a proper background. I'm thankful for it. I really like it. I think it has a very, like, princess, Pixar, Disney sort of a vibe happening here, because of the colors and because of, like, how warm and balanced the colors are. Like, you know, green is repeating itself, brown is repeating itself, but it's not like in a patterny sort of a way. Like, it's creating a nice harmony. I like it. Like, I think you've done a pretty good job. You've also added like some detailed shots here, which I obviously like always enjoy. Hey guys, always upload detailed shots when you're doing your Instagram uploads, okay? You have that carousel option, use it. Post details. Let people see more on their phones. I think like the background is like pretty well done. Like, if it's your first time, I think you've done a pretty good job. My only suggestion is that try to pick more values. Like, right now I sense that your sense of shading is a little bit flat. Like, picking a darker value of the same hue, which you've not done everywhere, so I'm pretty sure it could be like a stylistic choice. If it isn't, it's always a good idea to add more dynamism using color. Like, throwing in splashes of yellow here will really balance out this image and bring in some like good solid warm light into it, which would introduce like even more power. Like, you know, like when you throw light on a character, the audience knows, okay, that's what you're supposed to look at, and the light dictates what the interpretation of that character is going to be. And the character can be like human, non-human, object, whatever. Like, the character could be planet Earth, like whatever it is, use your light well. I think that's the only thing that I want to add here. Apart from that, I think you've done a solid job. I really like your sign also. It's quite like pretty. That's it. Really good job, Mansha. Really, really excited to see what you're doing next. That thing applies to everybody, just by the way. Like, I'm excited to see what all of you do next, okay? So this is Abu. I remember Abu had uploaded a message. Maybe it was on one of the other like text channels, but it was basically something about aliens inhabiting, basically like there is a new species. Okay, I know I'm butchering your concept, Abu, but from what I remember, it was there is one species and there is one planet, and they're both coming together. Like, the species is coming to that planet, so both are new to each other. And I told Abu that I think it's a very story-driven concept. It needs more context in the visual itself. Right now, it just looks like a Mortal Kombat character. But I think I like the way that you've done the anatomy. It's quite stylized. I like your vision. I like that there's ponytails and like big biceps, maybe like blades on the ponytails. That's like I wouldn't want to fuck with these guys. Just that, like, I think build it more. I don't have enough information here to give you like solid feedback. So Soumya's submission says, in my fantasy world, if I could be anything, I would be perfectly good at whatever I set out to achieve. Don't we all? That's what I was trying to go for here. I just realized I forgot to render the floor here. Okay, so this one is without the floor and this one is with the floor. So we'll be looking at this one as the final submission. I really like it, Soumya. I really, really like it. You're one person that I wouldn't recommend joining my classes, because I think that you have enough foundational knowledge to build more on top of. Definitely study like more like how crystals are painted. That's not a part of my classes. But yeah, like study like how crystals are painted, because there's a very nice way that you can make them look like much, much better. I really like how you've done this, how you've done the skin tone. I really like how the hands are all like perfectly balanced. There's a sense of symmetry in this frame, even though it's not like perfectly symmetrical, you know. I like what you're wearing. I like the crown. I like how stylized it is, and I like how it's a good balance of like stylized and realistic. I wish the background was a little bit more than just like a textural sort of a like purple. But apart from that, I really like it. Like, I think your background is just the only thing that's bringing the illustration down right now. But apart from that, it's really, really well done. Don't be afraid to like push your value scale a little bit more, like add stronger shadows, add stronger highlights. Not saying that that would necessarily work for this illustration, but I think it might even work for this illustration. I don't know. Like, when I'm visualizing it, it does work, but I'm not entirely sure. So those were all the submissions for this week. Okay, so this week's results which I'm really, really excited about. And more than anything, I'm excited about the number of submissions that came. Obviously, it's like 7. It's not a lot when you look at it from an outsider looking in. But as an individual, I'm happy, man. Like, I mean, more people are participating, and that's the biggest thing that I can, like, aim for. So, without further ado, let me get into my award giving routine. So, I said, this is what the categories are supposed to look like eventually, like, when I have enough people participating. Top 5 baby artworks, top 3 juniors, top 3 seniors, and top 3 grannies. Baby, junior, senior, and granny are levels of which are basically established based on how much time you've put in, like, digital painting. So since there weren't enough baby and junior artworks, I decided to merge those categories together. And this week's categories, top 5 baby and junior artworks. The first position in the top 5 baby junior categories goes to Soumya Sheel. The second goes to Saramya. Third goes to Sanki Khopri. Four goes to Mansha. And the fifth goes to Snoop Foodle. So all of you, really, really well done. And for those of you who are not here, you did a really good job. But there was just something that wasn't there. But that something is achievable by, like, regular practice. And if you keep at it, if you keep drawing, not these challenges, I'm not saying to be a part of this, but if you keep drawing by yourself, you're set. Just keep drawing and keep trying to see and learn more with each drawing that you make. All right, best visual style, Sanki Khopri, and best concept to Saramya. Just because in Sanki's, I could see, like, a really stylistic version of the character that he was creating. And the concept for Saramya, the concept that she created, I think had a lot of... it had a world around it in some sense. And I'm really, really excited and happy. Congratulations, all of you. I'm really tired, so I'm gonna go have some dinner with my family, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.